Might I be of service, sir?
Thank you.
hostile target detected. Put down your weapons and submit to authority.
line? Did I mention that my zone is forbidden to you? So forbidden. Everyone, calm down. Might have been a blip. You're no match for science. and robo-scorpions will soon conquer the crater. It's just that this is a big place, so it's hard to conquer everything.
I'm afraid I'm quite good at killing things. You may want to...
Beware Dr. Mobius' army. His robo-scorpions crawl everywhere in search of intelligence to devour and stupefy. Attention, students. This is the pre-recorded voice of your pre-recorded principal, Dr. Principal Boros. You may know me as the head chief researcher of labs Z9 and Z14. There I fought valiantly to preserve rattlesnake DNA and put it right where it belongs, in the husk of another feared predator.
Oh, and the tarantula hook.
Can't splice enough, I always say.
Especially if you can make a magnificent cazador.
Enough about me. It has come to my attention that many of you seemingly innocent children have been subverted by Red propaganda. This is a most serious matter, requiring the most serious of detention. Cybernetic cyborg dogs through the corridors to weed all you traitors out. They will sniff out which among you have chosen the commie path.
Especially you, Betsy Bright,
who turned you down for the high school dance so you could smoke with Richie Marcus. Hall monitors will also be vigilant. Step outside during class, and they'll make sure you make a speedy jump back to your desk. Hold your urine and wait for the proper bathroom break time.
Wasn't that shut down for some reason?
Open and identify yourself. Law-abiding citizens have nothing to fear. Do not be alarmed.
sorry I put your brain in a bowl.
Good boy.
Oh, who's a good boy? You are.
Thank you.
You recovered the sonic image schematics. You wasn't the frequency. No matter. It'll broadcast your screams as my roboscorpions destroy you.
Good day, citizen. Library Processing Unit 232.7 is online and ready to eradicate sedition. Of course, citizen. That's my duty and sole joy in life. All those books from before the war, full of seditious, treasonous, complicated thoughts. Just dump them in and lickety-split, I'll have them pumped, scrubbed clean, and pressed out again clean and white, and sedition-free. What good is eradicating sedition if the malcontents have ready access to the means to make more, citizen? I can also process pencils and clipboards. Wait a moment. Pencil processors offline? Pencil processors offline? Apologies, citizen. It seems traitors have absconded with that module. If you can find a backup copy of the module, I will happily eradicate your ability to create seditious literature. Blank books are better for the mind, citizen. Real science by real men in lab coats has proved that introducing outside thoughts confuses the brain. Blank books encourage the reader not to question, but to blindly and zealously accept what's put in front of him. Also, I suppose you could use them to keep a journal. Citizen, that sounds dangerously seditious. If my reindoctrination module was installed, I'd take care of that for you. Sadly, that system was cut for budget concerns, so you'll have to perform your own indoctrination. Now, to begin with, you'll need a cage that can fit over your head and a sack of mole rats. Now you're thinking like a citizen, citizen. Stay loyal, citizen.
Acoustical wizard kid. Old Doc Moe used me to prototype his sonic weapon designs. Get me a good sample base to work from, and I can whip up a wave that makes Jericho look like a kazoo. Got yourself a sonic emitter, don't you? Thought so. Bring that old thing on in here and bring me some sound samples, and I'll make that baby sing. Or scream, if that's what you want. Why not? Ain't like I got nothing to prove. Not like that toaster. Now that boy got some issues. Lay it on me, mama. Right on, baby. Just plug it in and I'll mix you up a sweet, sweet sound. Used to. Long time ago. Then old Doc Moe ripped out my music drives and stuck in more acoustical processors. Guess you could say I got the blues, even if I can't play them no more. Right on, baby. Let's spin some grooves.
How about that? Old Autodoc's back online. Well, all right, come here. Let's have a look at you. Well, firstly, I would say providing wholeness of the body is service enough, but if you must know, I'm also programmed with cosmetical subroutines. Diagnostics says they're offline at the moment, though. Something about corrupted data files and all manner of such foolishness. If you want a haircut or a nose job that won't leave you looking like a ghoul with alopecia, you'll have to find replacement discs for them. Also, and I won't swear to this, but I recollect at some point having a few implant installation modules. Can't speak to where they got to, though. And rightly so, I should think. All right, then. Let me just fire up the old interface for you. Forceps, nurse. This man's got a severe case of shoe lung. You require some additional services? And rightly so, I should think.
Partial functionality restored. That's less than optimal. Oh, well, that's very sweet of you. Maybe one of these nights we can discuss theorems. Slow down there, Tiger. We've got all the time in the world. No need to rush into things. Why don't you take some time to brush up on your knowledge so we can keep things stimulating? Dr. Mobius and I were deeply involved in research on the ability of light levels to enhance human cognition. We observed a fascinating phenomenon. Certain spectra of visible light actually increased cognitive function and reasoning ability. Of course, Dr. Mobius's brain is so big already, we had a hard time measuring it. As much as I'd love to, I'm afraid not. The data from that study has gone missing. You'll have to find a backup if you want to use the smart lights. Certainly, I'm looking forward to it.
I am online once again! Tremble, world, before my electric heating coil of doom! You should be afraid! I am the scourge of all small appliances, and the boogeyman that keeps lesser toasters awake at night! Not just murder! I tear them apart and render them down to their base components. Once their guts are spilled, you can do with them what you like. You want some weapon schematics? I can show you some fucking weapon schematics. You want a superheated Saturnite power fist? I can hook that shit up! You find one, you bring it on back here. And we'll burn this mother down! Like I said, bring me a Saturnite Power Fist, and I'll hook that shit up for you! Oh, baby. That is a thing of fucking beauty. Give it here. I'll soup it up for you. There you go. Have fun with that. Burn the fucking world for me! A toaster is just a death ray with a smaller power supply. As soon as I figure out how to tap into the main reactors, I will burn the world! Have you ever tried to indulge in all-consuming urge to kill when you don't have opposable thumbs? Or hands? Or anything other than a bread slot? You'd have a lot of pent-up anger, too. Buddy, if my heating element were just a little bigger, you'd be on fire right now! On fire! Well, since I can't kill you, I guess I have to listen to your inane questions. Yes! Flee before my terrible power!